Hey, Brainiacs, quick question. Would you take a punch from Mike Tyson for $1 million? Now, before you answer, you should probably know that this is a man who has wrestled with tigers, won 44 of his 58 fights by knockout, and whose punching power is rumored to have even scared the great Muhammad Ali. And while $1 million is $1 million, it's tough to spend all that money if you're confined to a hospital bed for the rest of your life. So the question you have to ask yourself is, how powerful is a punch from Iron Mike, really? When Mike Tyson burst onto the boxing scene back in 1985, he quickly made a name for himself as a ferocious boxer, known for his elite speed, accuracy, timing, and yes, raw power. Tyson became the youngest undisputed heavyweight champion of the world ever at just 20 years old. And it wasn't a surprise. After all, the man won his first 19 professional fights by knockout, most of which occurred in the first round, and he's on record as having knocked out pro fighters in as little as 30 seconds. So clearly Tyson packs a hell of a hook. Unfortunately, we don't know exactly how hard the self-proclaimed baddest man on the planet hit, as he never got his punching power officially measured in his prime, but we can guess, based on the recorded power of some of his hard-hitting contemporaries. One estimate puts Tyson's punching power at 1,178 pounds of force, which is the equivalent of having a 221-pound anvil dropped on your face from 5 feet. His punches were so strong, they lifted his opponent's feet off the ground, and these are 200-plus-pound professional heavyweight fighters I'm talking about. There's even a popular myth going around to this day that Tyson had to register his fists as lethal weapons in the state of Ohio due to the potentially deadly power of his punches. So how is it that Tyson was able to hit so hard? The biggest reason for this is that Tyson was able to put his whole body into his punches. Let's pause for a second. Imagine you were asked to throw your strongest punch. What do you think that would look like? A big wind-up, a wildly swung fist? While many people tend to think of punching as predominantly an arm movement, the reality is a strong punch requires precision and the activation of muscles throughout your entire body. After all, the more of your mass and acceleration you can put into a punch, the stronger it'll be. Bruce Lee's famous one-inch punch is probably the best demonstration of this concept. The whole premise is that a punch from just 1 inch away, delivered with proper technique and the puncher's full body weight behind it, can generate far more power than a punch thrown just using your arm strength and weight from a foot away. For this reason, a lot of boxing coaches say that a strong punch actually starts from your legs. It makes sense. Your legs are your biggest muscle group, and involving them in your punch allows you to generate much more power than using just your shoulder and triceps muscles alone. And yes, Tyson's explosive power was actually closely linked to his ability to engage his legs. He was known for crouching just before throwing a devastatingly powerful hook or uppercut, using his legs to spring up like a little jack-in-the-box full of pain. However, while all these things helped Tyson punch harder, these are techniques that anyone can work on to improve their power, and tons of professional boxers have mastered them. So what gives Tyson that explosive edge that makes him so powerful? Professional fighters would be scared of getting in the ring with him. Well, Tyson's technique was impeccable. He was known for drilling moves thousands of times until they became essentially reflexes. It was his vicious mentality that really set him apart, though. Tyson was a ferocious bad man, famous for telling fighters he'd eat their babies and even go as far as to bite off Evander Holyfield's ear during a fight. The man was willing to win at all costs, and every punch he threw was delivered with lethal intent, with hopes of breaking his opponent's ribs or exploding their liver. Seriously, this guy was not just trying to punch his opponent, he was trying to punch through them. And while you can train yourself to focus and get angry in the ring, that kind of honey badger-esque mentality just can't be taught. Oh, and speaking of things you can't teach, you have to be an exceptionally gifted athlete to be a championship boxer, and Tyson had natural talent in spades. At just 12 years old, Tyson was allegedly already 190 pounds of lean muscle and was capable of knocking out professional fighters who were twice his age. seriously. At 12 years old, he was winning fights against 27-year-old men. Sheesh. Now, some of you are probably thinking, yeah, sure, Tyson could hit really, really hard, but that was in his prime. He's like 50 years old now. Surely he's lost his edge. Unfortunately for you, my naive friend, punching power is said to be the last thing to leave a boxer's arsenal. While pros undoubtedly begin to lose more as they age, that's usually because their reflexes have slowed or their speed has declined, not because they can't punch as hard. So even if his punching power has declined slightly due to all his gray hairs, chances are if Tyson put all of it into a punch, well, you'd know all about it. And if you're still unconvinced, there are actually videos of Tyson running boxing drills at age 53. Let's just say his combos still look absolutely devastating. Now, I'm hoping that all of this has been enough to dissuade you from thinking of taking that punch. But if the promise of $1 million is still too tantalizing, I don't blame you. Well, you should probably get to know the best way to take a punch. Believe it or not, there's actually science to getting punched in the face. And if you perfect it, you might actually walk out of this friendly wager on your own 2 feet. The first step, ironically, is to relax. This may seem next to impossible when you've got Mike Tyson lining up his fist next to your jaw, but trust me, it'll reduce the impact of the hit if you're nice and loose. Think of it like catching a ball at high speed. If your hands are hard, catching it will hurt. But if they're nice and soft, the impact is lessened. Of course, in this case, the ball is Mike Tyson's fist and the hands are your face, but the concept still applies. The next step, again, perhaps counterintuitively, is to watch the punch coming. While you may still prefer the thought of closing your eyes and being surprised by it, boxers unanimously agree that it's the punches you don't see coming that hurt the most. By watching it as it comes, your body will know how to respond in a way that minimizes damage. Speaking of minimizing damage, our last recommendation is to try to roll with the punch. If you've ever watched pro boxers, you'll know that they rarely ever get caught square in the face. What often happens is that as a punch connects, they'll roll their face in the direction that the punch was going. By doing this, you'll still feel the impact, but the overall damage is lessened since your face will be heading in that direction anyway. Finally, if Tyson's okay with taking a quick rain check on the whole punching thing, we'd also recommend that you spend a year or two building up your neck muscles. Boxers tend to have really thick neck and trap muscles to prevent their heads from being whipped around when they get punched, which decreases their chances of receiving a concussion and losing consciousness. And since Tyson was capable of knocking out opponents who had these muscles, I'd recommend you take some time to build them up for yourself. And if not, well, good luck. Well, there you have it. All the info you need to decide whether or not you would take $1 million to get punched in the face by Mike Tyson. So, now that you know all the facts, would you? If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe below. Then head over to the Brainiac YouTube channel for more brain-busting facts and fun videos. See you next time.